everyone. It's the Wednesday afternoon. Welcome back to the roof. We're here for adagio stretch. So 1 hour deep release, a deep stretch. We're gonna move everything really, really slowly, give you time to get deep into your joints, into releasing your hips, releasing all the tension from your body. And let's just use this hour to slow our breath, slow our thoughts, and just go internal, really quiet. What do you need for this class? Not too much. A soft surface to either kneel or lie on. We'll be doing both in the class. This is very useful if you have one at home, a band, but I know most of you don't. Instead, a long rolled up towel in a tube shape, or a scarf. I would assume that most of us have a scarf. We're going to use this at some point under our foot for assisting us in the stretch, so just keep that nearby. And I am fortunate enough to have some yoga blocks at home. If you have them, fantastic. If you do not, a pillow under one hand, under each hand, would be helpful. Something that raises you up off the floor and can provide a support for under your back. A couple stacks of books are also good for the part of the class where we're placing them under our hands, but keep that pillow nearby as well. We're going to place it under our mid-back at some point. Okay, so blocks or books, pillow or two pillows ideally, and a scarf or a band or a towel and a tube. I'm just going to get the music started and we'll get moving here. Remember, you can contribute to the class via our Instagram bio to Shopify, through MindBody, or via e-transfer to info@extensionroom.com. And proceeds from classes this week are going to Black Lives Matter and Black Food Toronto. Please, please help us support these very important causes and be a part of the conversation, be a part of the movement that is so, so vital right now. Okay. Let's get going. Just find your spot on your mat or your smooth part of the floor. We're going to arrange our blocks, one on either side of your mat. Start is in a really wide parallel position, and just let's get grounded into the mat. I'd like you to lift your toes and spread them wide, so open up the spaces between the metatarsals, and then replant. We're going to take the arms up the outside, lift the shoulders up to the ears, let the arms fall across the chest, and lift everything up, breathing back to fold all the way down. Flat back, tabletop. Relax the head at the bottom. Just hang. Hold it here. You may want to adjust how wide your feet are. Nice and wide. Heavy hanging. Deep plie. Sink way down. And slow stretch. Push the floor away. And again, plie. Deep bend. Dropping your tail heavy. And slow stretch. Keep bringing your weight forward out of your heels. Deep plie, sink. Inhale. And exhale, stretch those legs. Once more, final plie, sink. Drop, drop, drop. And stretch. I'd like you to walk your hands over to the right side, to the right diagonal. Push the floor away, sink back into your left hip. Drop your chest through the arms, strongly pushing the floor away. And then I'd like you to reach up with that right arm, push the left hand into the floor, gaze up, place the hand behind the back, and roll the shoulder open as you push the back of the hand into your spine. four counts here, three, two, increase that twist, and then release, and drop that arm down. You're gonna walk your hands back to the center, and now over to the left side, push the floor away. Drop the chest through the arms. Hold it here, four more counts. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Opening up with that left arm, reach up to the sky, drop it behind the back, place the hand against the back, and roll the shoulder open. Four more counts, three, two, and one. And release that arm back down. Put your hands back to the center once more, and just hang. Weight forward out of your heels. Tipping your pelvis forward, tailbone sits bones high, and plie, bend your knees. And slow stretch. We're gonna bend our right knee now. Shift your weight over and drop as deep as you can to the inside of that left leg. And back to the center, over to the second side. Drop and sink, 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 sink. And center. Coming back to your palms if you were on your elbows. We're gonna take the arms out to either side, reaching wide. Clasp them behind your back, pull straight up as you tip forward again. We're gonna start rolling up through our spine, slowly, 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 slowly. Drawing the shoulder blades down the back, arms back up the outside, and turning out. And open wide, and plie. Open wide, plie, place that arm on the thigh, circle the arm all the way around, place it behind the back, roll it open again, gazing up, and back through to the second side, drop that arm on the thighs, circle the arm independently, open up the shoulder joint, place the elbow behind, the hand behind the back, press into it, open up, and gaze up. And then release once more, back to the center. We're gonna walk our feet slowly in, feet together, take a big breath up. I'm going to turn myself sideways on the mat, facing the blocks. Palms facing forward. Start flat back diving all the way down until you find the floor. I'd like you to walk forward. Place one hand on either block or pillow or stack of books. Push back into those heels. Tip your pelvis forward. Tail high. We're going to raise all the way up and drop those heels. Push those palms firmly into the blocks or the pillows or the floor. One more. We're going to step forward with our right foot about 2.5 feet or 2 feet between that front heel and the back toe, squaring the hips as much as you can. Bending your front knee, shift forward, and push back, draw that hip bone back. Once more, bending, shifting forward, and exhale, shift back. Hold it here, drop the head, release the neck, stay down. I'd like you to cross your left hand on the right block, push down, reach up into the twist. And lower it once more. Find those blocks. Pull to the end of the phrase. Draw that front kneecap up the thigh. We're going to bend that back knee. Lift the front toes up. Draw them up towards the shin. Feeling the stretch running through the calf. And plant it once more. We're going to step back now. Take your plank position, shoulders stacking high over the wrists. And lift the right leg. Rocking forward, draw the knee right up to the chest. Turn it on its outside edge and slowly lower. Ease yourself down into the middle. That lunge. Use the floor, push down to square the hips. Gonna lift up with the left arm, inhale. And exhale, fold to the right block, placing your head on the block or the pillow. And exhale, drop your weight down. Take that left arm and place it behind your back. Or the right arm. Back up. I'd like you to place your left hand on your right thigh. Push down strongly and spiral. See if you can find the back leg with that right hand. Spiral. Your back knee to a 90 degree angle, no more. Place your pillows or your blocks behind you. We're going to form a platform for our back. Our right leg will extend to straight. We're going to slowly ease ourselves back first onto our elbows, just onto the elbows, and see if we can feel the length running through the front of that left hip, driving the hip bone up towards the ceiling. Closer to your seat, your left heel closer to your seat, and then release the head back. And just let the weight of the body fall onto the floor. Again, continuously driving that hip bone up to the sky. And let's just hold our elbows, drop the arms over our head, open the chest. Ourselves up very slowly. We'll take our weight onto our right elbow. Use your left hand to help cross the body. Push firmly to the floor to bring yourself back up. And we'll lengthen that back leg and come right in the center, right in the middle, dropping your weight into the front of that hip. then if your knee feels comfortable, let's bend and find that foot. I'm going to start with the straight back arm, giving yourself a stretch through the chest and the bicep. Let the weight of the foot fall into the hand and drop deeper in the plie. Lift up, gaze up. Open your throat. Open your chest. And then if you'd like, you can take it further into the quadricep. Bring the heel closer to the stomach. And then slowly release. We're going to lift our weight up and back onto our heels. Find those blocks or pillows beside you. Place them once more in front of you. One hand on each. Drop your chest through and sink your weight through the arms. Taking your left hand, place it on your right block. Interlace right fingers through the left. Press the heel of the palm into the top of the hand and sink. It's as if you're pulling that arm out of the socket. Or pillows behind you, rolling up through the spine. Place one hand on each and push firmly down as you drive the hips up to the sky. Let the head fall underneath through right arm, underneath find the left elbow or the forearm, and tuck your chin, pull yourself in. Stretch. stretch running up the outside edge of that leg. And the back arm releases up and over the top, takes the foot from the underside, crossing the wrist, and let the weight of the leg fall into the hips. So we're not supporting, we're dropping it heavy. Feeling the back of the knee open up. And then I'd like you to contract and ground your spine as much as you can. Tuck your chin. Start to push the foot into the hands. Feel the stretch across the upper back until it's straight, and then sit up tall, up out of your hips. And once more, contract, round, drop the chin. Keep the back rounded as you start to push, and sit up tall, let your head fall back. And turn it out, flex the foot, place it in the elbow, and rock it side to side. And massaging that foot up and down. And then slowly slide it inside the inner thigh. You're going to flex that foot, hold on to the outside edge, and fold yourself down over that leg. Pressing the back of the knee down into the floor. Drop the head heavy. Loose. Push that left palm into the floor to help you go a little deeper. Pull those toes up strong. And then slowly release, roll the body up. Good, you're gonna place that foot once more on the leg. Take your scarf or your band, keep it close, over your lap, place it over your lap. I'm going to shift forward one pace so we have room to roll down on the mat. Take your time to slowly unfold through your spine. Slowly, all the way down onto your back. Arms up, opening the chest to the ceiling or the sky. We're going to take our palms and place them over our eyes, over our brow bones, so that our eyelids fall shut and everything rests heavy on the face. Just let the weight of the hands drop into the eye sockets. Let everything fall heavy. Feel very nice on those eyelids. One more deep breath, fill the lungs. And then as you exhale, slide the hands off the eyes. Open the arms to either side. We're going to bring everything up in one piece. Curl up to meet it. And then bend that top leg. Drop everything back to the mat. Pull the whole shape closer to you. In this position, I'd like you to think that you're arching your back. So we're pressing our tailbone into the floor, tipping our pelvis forward, and then release, imprint your low back, imprint your spine. And then again, arch, lift your low back up, press your tail into the floor, keep pulling those legs towards you, and then imprint, rock your pelvis. And then this time, take hold of that top leg, slide the bottom leg out to straight. And you're going to massage the hip bone, opening up the angle at the knee. Go a little higher, heel, and then down. Once more, keep pulling that foot toward you as you do so. And then we're going to close the knee to parallel. I'm going to slip the band under the foot. Take hold of either side of your scarf or your band. Pull your elbows to the floor and then slowly push your heel up towards the ceiling, opening up behind the knee. Inhale, bend. Exhale again. Keep those elbows planted in the floor. Pull that foot a little closer if you can. Once more, inhale. And exhale. And then we're going to release the weight of the leg. Just guide it down with that scarf or band. And then gently pull it up. Try not to take any work into the leg, into the hip socket. You want all the work to be done by the arms, and just let the leg rest gently in the hip socket. Closer, 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 closer. And then this time, take two sides of your scarf or your band together. Hold them with your left hand only. Right arm out to the side, palm down. And as you let the leg fall to the side, to the right, pull your left elbow back like a bow and arrow, and let the weight of the leg fall into whatever the support is, the scarf or the towel or the band. Keep pulling that elbow back. If you'd like, you can add a second hand and pull everything closer towards the body. Just be gentle. We're going to lift that bottom leg up and just float the whole shape in one piece. Bring your focus back to your breath, nice and slow, filling the lungs a little deeper, a little fuller. And then lower that bottom leg once more. We're going to carry the leg across the body, change hands. Right hand holds the band or the scarf, and continue until that foot touches down, and then pull that right arm back like a bow and arrow. Going to bend the knee, slide the heel in towards you, slide it out again. See if you can lengthen it a little more, a little straighter. And exhale, last time. Breathe it in. So we're going to slip that band off the foot. Place your hand on the leg to keep it where it is, and open the chest. Drop the back shoulder blades to the floor. Open the chest. One more deep breath here. Fill the lungs. Circle the arm up, down the front of the body. Place the hand in front of you, bring yourself up onto your side. You're going to rock yourself forward and back. And just stay on your side, sinking into your side stretch. Then you're going to lower yourself down halfway. Take that bottom arm, extend it straight out in front, palm up to the ceiling. You're going to flip your body straight on top of it. And we're going to use our right hand as a pillow for our cheek. Turn our head to the left and drop your weight onto the arm. Drop the chest onto the arm. Hug the shoulder blade down the back. And then slide that arm out. Place one hand on either side of your chest. Gently press up into your back extension. Great. is your chin. And turn your head to one side. Back to center, slowly lower. Exhale, pressing up one more time. And inhale, slowly lower. Gently press up and back to your heels. Let's take our hands behind our back and just rest the forehead and the mouth. Slow breath. Inhale. And exhale. Once more. Now we're going to slide our hands forward and once more find our blocks or our pillows or our books. Or if you prefer not to use the blocks, hands just firmly on the mat, tuck our toes, lift up and back to our plank position, our feet, stretch once more, tailbone lifting high, high, high to the sky. Front of the back, again about 2 feet or 2.5 feet distance between the front heel and the back toes, squaring your hips as much as you can, lengthening down the front of that shin. We're going to take our right hand to the left block, push down firmly into the floor as you reach up into the twist, scoop your lower belly up, draw your inner thighs together. Slowly release back down, one hand on each block once more. Bend your front knee, shift forward, and gently shift back. Again, inhale, exhale. Lift your front toes, let your back heel left sink back into that flex. And then push back to two straight legs. We're going to step back to your plank once more. Stack your shoulders over your wrists. Hold it here. Left leg extends. And then draws right up knee to chest. Turn it on its outside edge. We lower. We ease down. Center, right in the middle of two legs, pushing the floor away. We're going to lift up with our right arm now. Exhale, fold to the left diagonal. Find the pillow or block, place your temple and your cheekbone on it. And just sink the weight into the floor. Place the left hand behind your back. One more deep breath, inhale. Thank you. to bend that back knee 90 degrees. We're going to place the blocks or the pillows once more behind us. And then as you start to come back onto your elbows, bring that heel a little closer. Extend the left leg out in front. And we'll just come first to our elbows. Just settle here and see how we feel. If you're not comfortable going further or if you're getting pain in your knee, just come back up and release the angle. If you feel like you can come back, do so. Tucking from underneath, pressing that hip bone up towards the sky. Draw your navel down. Let's connect to our core. And if you feel you'd like to go deeper, we're going to continue on down until our mid-back, between our shoulder blades, is placed on the pillows or the blocks. And the head just gently falls back. Taking your elbows once more. If you'd like to increase the stretch, bend your left knee, find your foot, place it on the right thigh, and just gently rest it, let it fall down, and press that left knee down towards the mat. Left hand press firmly through the forearm into the floor, right hand across the body. Help assist yourself up nice and slow, nice and slow, nice and slow. And straighten my mat here. And you're going to come back to the center, right in the middle of two legs. Rest the weight of the body into the head of that hip. Gently, gently release. Take your time, take your time. Push the top of the foot to the floor, lengthen the leg. And then see if you can gently lift up and back to your heels once more, placing the blocks or pillows in front, one hand on each, dropping the chest through. This time is the right hand crossing to the left block. Press the palm into the block. Heel of the left hand pressing into the top of the right hand and gently pull the arm out of its socket as you sink deeper. Yeah. down, lift the hips, drop the knees. Sliding now your right foot out, gently rest on the top, opening up the ankle, front of the ankle. Remember, you can control how much weight you give the foot by using your arms. And then shift back further until the stretch lowers down into the toe joints. In front, crossed, right arm, wrap around, sit up, spiral, twist. We're going to take that right hand, wrap it around the outside edge of the left foot, and unfold the leg. Crosses the other arm at the wrist, takes hold of that foot, let the weight of the leg fall into the hands. And then contract around your spine. Keep the contraction. Push, push, push. Strong, strong, strong. Up to straighten through the back, let the head fall. Once more, inhale. And exhale, push, 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 push. And drop the head back. Bring it closer. And then bend it. Place the foot in the crook of the elbow. Sit up tall. And you're going to rock side to side. And lift that foot up and down, massaging in that hip joint. To slip that foot inside the right thigh, quite high above the knee. I'm going to take the left arm up, cross to the outside edge of the foot, hold yourself down. You're going to flex that foot now. Push the back of the knee firmly into the floor. Back up, placing the foot on the leg, shifting forward one pace, take that scarf or band over your lap once more. And slowly take your time to roll all the way down onto your back. Palms up. Place the hands once more over the brow bone. Letting the heel of the palm drop, the eyelid closed. Heavy weight resting gently on the eyes. Deep breath, and as you exhale, slide the hands off the eyes, opening them to either side, and begin to raise the legs up in one piece, curl up, take hold of the legs, draw them towards the body. And then as you drop the head down, bend that top leg and bring the whole shape in towards you. And then try and arch your back slightly, press your tailbone into the floor, let your low back lift up slightly, and then imprint, rock your pelvis closer to you. And once more arch. Taking hold of that top leg, slide the bottom leg out to straight. Drop the head. Massaging in the hip. Guide that foot higher and lower. And then closing that knee to parallel. Take the band or the scarf underneath and push that heel up to the sky. Draw your elbows down, inhale, bend. Exhale, go further. Inhale once more. And exhale, extend. You're going to take the weight of the leg down, just guide it down with the hands. Try not to hold anything in the hip socket. No work through the leg, no work, no work, no work, no work. And again, guide it down gently. Just let the weight fall. And bring it up. And then you're going to take two sides of the scarf in one hand, your left hand. You're going to open your right arm out to the side, palm flat. Right hand holds the scarf, left arm is flat, and you're going to open the leg to the left as you pull the right elbow back. Just let the heavy weight of the leg fall into the band or the scarf or the towel, supporting it by tugging that right elbow back with the bone in. You're going to lift the bottom leg up, just let it float out in space. You can use the other hand to pull it closer towards you.
Covered in grace, cause you're walking a dime.
And then slowly lower bottom leg, carry the leg over the top, change hands. Keep rolling with it until the foot touches down. Pull that left elbow back. And just gaze up. We're going to bend the knees, slide the heel in towards you. And exhale, slide it. Once more, inhale. Exhale.
Took us 6 years and 4 days to finally get mad. Look at me.
And then slip that foot off the band. Place your hand on the leg to keep it where it is. Unfold the arm behind you. Open the chest to the sky. Just breathe into that twist.
Show me the light. Bring me back to Jesus Christ.
And you're going to release that leg. Circle the arm up over your head. Down the front of the body, place it in front of the body, bring yourself up onto your side for a side stretch. Just getting into that space between the bottom rib and the top of the hip, and you can rock it forward and back. Feel the stretch in different places, and then just sink the weight of the torso into the side bend. And then lowering yourself halfway down, arms straight out in front. We're going to flip our body forward, resting the weight of the torso on the arm. Left hand for a pillow for the cheek, turn your head to the right. Gently tug the shoulder blade down the back. That arm out. Place one hand on either side of your chest and once more press. Tuck your chin back to the center. This time we're going to lower halfway down and push right away back to our heels. Coming back to our hands and knees, let's shift and adjust so we're facing sideways on the mat. We're just going to take a gentle cross-legged position. I'd like you to place the left foot in front, and then we're going to lift it up and rest it on the left thigh or the knee. And we're going to just drop the head heavy. Slipping that foot a little further, cross it right over on top and let the knee fall down. We're going to twist towards that top knee and then just drop our weight forward over. Switch. Place the left foot in front and just settle here, and then place it on top of the thigh and drop the head. And then slipping that foot all the way across on the mat. We're going to start by folding towards that top leg. Push into the floor so you can help yourself release in the hip joint. And then a big side bend up and over. Feel the length running down the side of the body. Circling forward, drop the head heavy all the way around to the other side and hands over the toes and draw yourself down the center. Feel the breath expanding the width of the rib cage. And then as you slowly roll up, we're going to bring those feet a little closer and fold once more. Pull those toes up as you pull your body down. And we're going to keep holding the toes with your left hand and press down with the right palm. Push, push. And then switch hands, hold the feet, place the hand, and push down. Spiraling the other way. And then take your time to slowly close the legs. Come over onto your knees. We're going to plant our palms, tuck our toes, sit back into our lower calves, releasing the heels to the floor, and feel that stretch through the lower calf. The ankles releasing. And then we're going to open up to hip width and just hang. Draw the shoulder blades down, let the head fall back. As you come back up, arms over the top of the head. Take the back of the head, draw the chin down. And slowly float the arms down. And shift from foot to foot. Feel how your hip joints, the bones in your feet feel. And let's just take one final exhale. Thank you for being here tonight, everyone. I'll see you tomorrow for level 1 ballet at 12. Take tonight to be calm, to breathe, hydrate, and just listen. Thanks for listening.